Hello children and parents. As already communicated with you earlier, the school management is in the process of starting online classes soon. So today, I will be guiding you on how to access Google Classroom using your smartphone. Why Google Classroom? This is a very simple process and an effective tool which can be used by the teachers and students so that the teacher can interact with her students effectively. Teacher can upload assignments, give regular test, revision, upload study material and videos related to her subject. She can interact with the student individually. Students, on the other hand, can submit their assignments, give tests online, view the videos and download the study material that are uploaded by the teachers, and interact with the teacher and clarify their doubts. So without wasting much time, let us proceed on how to begin the Google Classroom. So dear children and parents, in order to access the Google Classroom, we must first install the app on our smartphone. So for that, we will go to Play Store and here in the search button, we will go for Google Classroom. Once when you search for Google Classroom, install Google Classroom will appear. Click on the Google Classroom to be installed, and once when it is installed, you will get this message as Google Classroom installed, and we will go for open. Now when you go on open, this is the screen that will appear in front of you. So say get started. Now here you will have to log on with the ID that the school will provide you with. Once when you log in with the ID, it will direct you to the Google Classroom page. Now there is two ways to log in to the classroom. The first method is by clicking on this plus sign and say join class. Now in order to join the class, you require a code that will be provided by your teacher. It is a 7-digit code containing alphabets and numbers. So let's say if teacher has given the code X66ZHZS and you say join. When you will join, it will direct you into the classroom created by your teacher. So this is the classroom that has been created by the English teacher for standard 3rd. And as you see over here, there is a new assignment that has been posted by the teacher. There is a new material that has been posted by the teacher. And there is a welcome note given by the teacher saying, "Hello children, welcome to Google Classroom." Now let us see this one at a time. The stream button will give you all the announcements made by the teacher from time to time. It could be something related to your assignment. It could be a new video that has been posted. It could be a new test that is to be conducted. Now in the classroom, you will be able to see the topics that are created by the teacher. In the English class, the first topic created by the teacher is Chapter 1, A Pretty Game. Now in this, if you notice, there is chapter 1, the poem is given. If you click on this, you will see a note given by the teacher saying, "Dear children, the poem A Pretty Game is about how the sun and the rain is playing a game of hide and seek in the sky." So there is a video that has been posted by the teacher. Simply click on it in order to view the video.
Chapter 1, A Pretty Game. Paraphrase, the poet says that the sun and
so as you see,
hide and seek in the sky.
There is a video that has been posted and you can revise your lesson from this particular video. Now coming back, let us see what is the assignment that has been given. Now in the assignment, teacher has given you an attachment. Now this attachment is a Google form. It is a type of online test. So after you revising with the video, whatever test is conducted by the teacher, see that you attempt it. So first, name of the student. So we'll just write down the name, followed by the division and the roll number. Now let us answer the questions and click on submit. After you submit, you will be able to see the score, how much you have scored in the test, and you can also open the assignment using the Google Classroom again to check if the assignment has been completed. Now below, if you notice, there is your work which has been assigned. So when you click on this, once when the work has been done, say mark as done, and you can write a private note to the teacher saying that your work is done. Your teacher will receive this private comment via email or when she logs into the classroom. Once when you have clicked on it, if you notice, your assignment which was first assigned has now been turned to handed in. Now this handed in indicates that the teacher will get your assignment and she will grade the assignment. That is, she will give marks for your assignment and you will receive the score by the email that will be sent to you by your teacher. Now coming back, we will go to the third tab, that is people. Here you will be able to see which teacher has created the classroom for you. So children, this is a very simple process. Just 1, 2 and 3. In this 3 steps, you will be able to upload your assignments, download the videos and the study materials, and also interact with your teacher and clarify whatever doubts you have. The second way to log into your classroom is by accessing the email sent to you by the teacher. For this, you will have to go to Gmail and log in. Once when you do that, the teacher has sent invitation for EVS class and for maths class. You simply have to click on the invitation and say join. When you say join, it will automatically direct you to the Google Classroom. There you have to select your email address with which you want to log in to your classroom, and it will take you to the classroom that has been created by the teacher, which is EVS Standard 3. You can view all the classrooms by going to these 3 slabs here and say classes. So now I am already been into 2 classes. One is for EVS standard 3, second is for English standard 3. Similarly, the other subject teachers will also either send you a link in order to enter the Google Classroom, or they may send you a code in order to join the classroom. So these are the two ways how you can join the Google Classroom. The remaining steps will be the same. Dear parents and children, now I will show you how to access Google Classroom using the laptop. Again, here there are two ways by which you can access the Google Classroom. The first method is by clicking on the link sent to you by your teacher. So for that, you will first go to Gmail. And enter the user ID and password provided to you by the school. As you see over here, there is a class invitation by maths teacher. So you just click on that invitation and say join. When you click on join, it will directly take you to your Google Classroom. So this is the classroom created by the maths teacher. You will be able to see the announcements posted on the first page, that is on the streams page. All announcements will be posted over here. The second tab, that is in the classwork tab, you will be able to see all the topics, different topics that are being covered up by the teacher. And in the people tab, you will be able to see who is the teacher who has created this particular classroom. Now, how is the using of laptop different from that of the Android phone? If you notice, here there is, towards the left hand side, there is a tab saying upcoming. Now, if there are any assignments posted and which are due, that is if teacher has set a particular date or a time within which you have to submit the assignment, those will be appearing in the upcoming assignments. So when you just click on view all, you will get the list of all the assignments that has been assigned to you. You will also be able to track in what are the assignments that are being assigned to you by clicking on the assigned button. You can also track whatever you have been returned to the teacher and whatever you have missed. Now, since over here there is nothing being posted, hence the page is blank. Now the second method, now if I want to come back to the start of the classes, I will just go on these three slabs and click on classes. So I have got three classrooms created by my teacher, English, EVS and Maths. The second way to join the classroom, I'll just come out of this. The second way to join the classroom is by clicking on these nine dots, and you will get a tab called as Google Classroom. So you click on this classroom. If you do not have this classroom tab, you can also type here as classroom.google.com. So this will also direct you to the page for your Google Classroom. So I'll show you using these 9 dots. We'll click here and go to Google Classroom. Click on it. It will direct you to the page of Google Classroom. Now, after coming here, this is your home page where you will be able to see what all classes have been created by the teachers. You will go to this plus icon and say join class. And you will copy paste the class code given to you by the teacher and say join. So this will take you to the class that is being created by the teacher for you. Now this code was created by the EVS2 teacher and she has given a list of work to be done. So on the stream page, you will be able to see the post that she has given. So the first one here we have is a welcome note followed by a material. Okay. So she has sent a material over here. So this is just a water cycle chart that she has prepared. So you can study the chart. And after revising the entire chart, then you can see the assignments, what is being assigned to you. So we'll come back to EVS2 class and go to class work. Now in the class work, under chapter 1, here there is an assignment that is being given. So we'll just click on this assignment to see what is the assignment given by teacher. This is a water chart and you have to label the diagrams. So these are the different tools that are available over here. So you can go to these tools and you can complete the labeling. Now in order to label, we require a text box. So we will go to this text box over here, click on it and just label. So just drag it and mention. So you will write over here clouds. Click on this again and mention here as sun. Click here again and say rain. Okay, so we have done the labeling. Now this has to be handed to your teacher. So once when this is done, it is automatically saved. So we close this out. Now this has been assigned. So we have to now hand over this to your teacher in order for grading this particular assignment. Now once after you completing your assignment, you will have to click on this tab again, view assignment, and just check the assignment before sending it to your teacher. Okay, so we'll just see whether all the labels are still intact. That is, we have got the clouds, the sun, then we have got the rain, which means that our work is completed. Now we'll just close this page. And we have to hand in to the teacher. So we will hand this in. It will ask you one attachment will be submitted. Do you want to continue? Say hand in. Now when you hand in the work, your assigned work has now changed to handed in, which means that your teacher will get this project or this assignment of yours. And she will grade it, that is, she will give marks to it and she will send it back to you where you will be able to see your score. Now, again, to come back to the main page, we will click on the three slabs and say
classes. So we have got four classrooms that have been created by teacher. In the same manner, you will follow all the steps as given in the previous slides, so that it becomes easy for you to manage your classrooms and to submit your assignments.